So now moving ahead, I will be creating one more comp here. So I'll just maybe duplicate this comp and I'll name this as light wrap. And coming here, I'll be deleting all these contents as I do not want them anymore. So inside my light wrap, I will be taking this keying. So I've taken here and now I'll be inserting my BG over here. So I've got my BG here. So I've already named this as BG. So this is the BG which I want to add here. It's actually taking some time here. So yeah, so this is the BG which I want to load. I'll just drag and drop this right up here. So I've got this. It's a 1920,080. No issues. I'll just name this as BG. I'll duplicate this. I'll take this up right here. I'll rename this as light wrap. So if you can see here, if I play this, if I just turn this off, this is what I get. So I've got this light wrap above my keying layer. That's totally fine. So I've got my light. So this layer is above this, my keying layer. And if I turn this off, I get this. So what I'll do first is, I'll go here in my effects and presets. I'll go to my effect controls. I'll add a fast blur. So I've taken this fast blur and I'll drag and drop this right up here inside my light wrap. So right now, if you can see, there is no blurriness here. So because the value is 5, so I'll change this to maybe 20. So I've changed this to 20 and I can see there is slight of blur. Then what I'll do here is, I'll go here inside my, select this layer and I'll go to effect. I'll go to channel and then I'll say set mat. So inside my set mat, it says take mat from layer 1 light wrap. I will say no, don't take it from light wrap, but take it from keying. So I've taken this from keying over here. If you can see, now what I'll do is I'll add, if you can see, the an edge is being appeared here. So this is the edge what I have got. Now what I'll be doing is, if I turn this to solo, this is what I get. Now I'll be adding a channel blur over here. And inside my channel blur, I'll insert my alpha blurriness so that I get this kind of effect over here. If you can see this effect. And now what I'll be doing, I'll be duplicating this set mat too. I'll be coming over here. I'll say invert mat. Yeah, I'll invert for this over here. So this would remain the same and this set mat, and I have inverted this over here so that I get this very nice blur kind of effect over here on my edges, so that the reason being they mix with my background. So if I play this, so this light wrap has been now created, if you can see this on the edges. And now if I turn my solo off, this is what I get. And now if I check this on and off, this is what I get. So now what you have to do is, you have to actually tweak with this, the values of the light wrap. So I'll be changing this down to screen maybe. So by default it was normal over here. I'll be changing this down to screen. Let us see if it's a major difference or not. So a screen is actually creating a white kind of glow, which is not looking natural. So I would prefer to keep this to normal. So right now it's in normal over here. Yeah. And even these hair details are pretty much been preserved. Let's make this to maybe 15, right up here. And alpha blurriness to maybe somewhere over here, around this, maybe 33 or something. Now if I check this on and off, this is what I get. Now what you have to do is I'll be turning this on and then I'll be decreasing down its opacity to maybe 75. So it's a blend of both. Now if I play this, this is what I get. It's actually taking some time to. So what I'll do is I'll just first cache this and then I'll be showing you. So go to Windows, you can go to Preview over here, and then there is an option known as RAM Preview, which is this. So I've just clicked over here and it'll take some time to cache. Before that, I'll just save this file. So I've just saved this file and now I'll be again caching this. It's actually rendering in full over here. So I'll just go for 100 frames or something over here. And if you can see on the edges, it's creating a very nice illumination of our background. So it's actually magic and some tweaks through our software, which can create some very natural kind of effect, which was not present at the time of shoot. That's the power of a visual effects or a compositing software. Now if I play this, so this is what we get. It's for the 100 frames. So it's looking pretty much natural. And this is how you got to work with your keyers and light wraps. I hope you are able to understand the topic of light wrap.